Σας παρακαλώ κύριε, σας παρακαλώ κύριε.
Αυτό είναι ένα
I have no statement to make. I intend to make a statement at the airport. I just to see Mr. Denktash. As you know, I'm going to see him now, and I think it is more appropriate that I make my statement when I arrive at the airport. So please have understanding when I see you at the airport in about an hour or so.
Dr. Wallstein, when you say that the Turkish proposal Dimitri at the airport, please.
No, just one question for our item.
When you say, Dr. Wallstein, that the Turkish proposals are concrete and substantial, do you mean that IBTEX made the proposal to take the whole of Cyprus, the whole of Cyprus?
I have no comments to make. I have told you that I should.
Let's go.
Εγώ θα δώσω δημοσιογραφική διάσκεψη το απόγευμα.
His position, the position of the Greek side, Greek Cypriot side, to the Turkish proposals. Evidently, there is still considerable disagreement on the basis on which the intercommunal talks should be resumed. I'm now going back to New York. I shall study the situation in the light of the talks I had here in Nicosia. You know that after my talks with Mr. Kyprianou, I had also talks with Mr. Denktash, who explained his position to me. In fact, the Turkish proposal, as you know, have been given to me already in Vienna, so that I knew the Turkish position before coming here. I shall study the situation further in New York, and I shall then decide on my steps, on the steps to be taken in regard to the negotiating process, taking into account the conversations and talks I had here in Nicosia, and of course further developments.
Dr. Vatkai, when you say that the Turkish proposals are concrete,
interpreted that I wanted to make a judgment on the merits or the substance, the content of the proposals.
Do they satisfy the United Nations resolution, sir?
This is not the question. The question is whether the intercommunal talks can be resumed on the basis which have been made recently by the Turkish side.
Can we assume?
And let me finish. And as you know, there is an agreement which was reached here in Nicosia in January, which says that the proposals should be given to the Secretary General, that he should study them and consult with the parties, in other words, with the other party, and then to decide on the resumption of the talks.
But all of us have good basis for the resumption.
How long will it take you to study the position of the two sides?
Well, I cannot give you a concrete answer to this question. I shall certainly see to it that this will be done as quickly as possible.
Well, out of that time, when you were in Ankara, you got the promise for Mr. Ecevit that you would have the Turkish proposals in 1 or 2 weeks' time. After what happened, how can you depend on new promises from the Turkish side that they will fulfill their promises?
Well, this is history. We have the proposals now and we have to concentrate.
A good basis for resuming talks, the Turkish proposals, are a good basis of
Well, I told you already that I can nothing add to what I said in this regard.
Mr. Behrman, have you asked or recommended to the Greek side that they attend the resumed talks? And what was their answer?
I had a very intensive exchange of views with President Kyprianou, and we have discussed the proposal in all its aspects. I gave him the proposals so that he is fully informed.
What about
he will make himself his views known because I cannot speak for the Mr. Kyprianou.
What about
Mr.
Katsambas? Please, Mr. Katsambas.
Are you now in a stage at which you are trying to make the Turkish proposals better?
Well, the next step, of course, is to decide on the intercommunal talks because. It has been agreed upon long ago that the negotiating process should take place in the intercommunal talks under the auspices of the Secretary General. So this is the question.
Well, do you think that talks can now be started?
I cannot give you an answer. I told you that.